Hi and welcome to another Bitwig Studio Masterclass. My name is Mattias and it's finally time to talk about the modulators of Bitwig. The modulators is a powerful feature of Bitwig to induce a movement into your sounds. And it's really a game changer. So let's take the tour. You probably heard of the powerful modulators in Bitwig Studio. And the modulators are basically data modifiers. It's certain devices in Bitwig Studio that can modify parameter and data values of other plugins and devices in Bitwig. So we can begin by looking at an example with a dream pad from our song sketch. So we solo the dream pad and look at the equalizer device. If we look closely to the leftmost side of any device in Bitwig Studio, you notice this little key. It's called the Show Modulators button. But I call it the skeleton key because it basically looks like a small key. If you press that button, you open the slots for the modulator devices. And if we press the plus sign to add a modulator device, we get to see all the different modulator devices available in Bitwig Studio. The most common modulators that I use from the modulator devices in Bitwig Studio are basically the classic LFO, which is a low frequency oscillator. An LFO will basically generate a different curve. You can have it to generate sawtooths, sine waves, triangles, or some other kind of curve like a random. And these curves will apply different data values to your modulation. You can also add modulators like buttons and macros. So you get this parameter knob that you can use. And another useful modulator is the random modulator, which will basically throw a dice and generate different data values. But let's first look at the classic LFO. So we have the classic LFO, and you can see it generates this sine wave. And you can change the hertz, the rate of this LFO, to make it go faster or slower. Probably the best way to demonstrate the modulator is to actually hear how they can sound. If you want to attach a modulator to some parameter of your plugin, you can press this the blue key here, which will start the activation process or the mapping process. We can actually first create a new node in our equalizer and make it a peak EQ curve like this. Again, press the mapping button here on the modulator and move some parameter. In this case, I'm moving the frequency of that specific equalizer node. Now we instantly see that the modulator is affecting this frequency value of this equalizer node with the low frequency oscillator. Now we can deactivate the mapping and open the expanded view for the equalizer. So you can see this equalizer in a more expanded view. Now let's press play and hear how this sounds on the pad. You can hear we get this kind of phasing effect when we have the modulator affecting the frequency of our equalizer. Now, if you want this modulator to work in sync with your time in your arrangement, you need to activate the beats mode. And here we can select quarter notes, eighth notes, 16th notes, etc. to get different effects and have this LFO perfectly in sync with our arrangement. And if you want a more subtle effect from this modulator, you can always reduce the amount. That's the amount that this modulator will affect the parameters. Now it's quite obvious that we're modulating the equalizer curve, the frequency here of the equalizer curve. But if you want to see what kind of parameter a certain modulator is affecting or modifying, you can press the modulator and look in the information panel. And here we can see that the classic LFO is affecting the frequency band number 3 of the equalizer. And you can also change the values that modulator affects this parameter directly here from the information panel. So it's a really good overview of what the modulator does. Okay, so let's deactivate this modulator by right-clicking and select active. And now it's deactivated. Now we will use a modulator to create a volume gating effect. So after the equalizer, press the plus sign and add a tool device. The tool device is a great plugin in Bitwig to affect volume, to change the volume and gain and panning, and the width of your stereo field. Again, press this skeleton key to open up the modulator section and add the classic LFO again. We press the modulator to open up the parameter list for the classic LFO, change the modulator to a ramp and activate the beat so it's in sync with our arrangement. Now start the modulator mapping by pressing this blue key and attach it to the volume. For this volume gating effect, we only want the LFO to go downwards, so we deactivate the bipolar button here. And bump the rate up to 8 notes. And let's play back and hear how it sounds. Now create the second LFO by pressing this other slot for our modulators and add a classic LFO again. Select the new modulator and make sure it's synced to our beat. And we select 8 notes and the ramp again. So this one is like halftime of our 16th notes. And attach this one to the panning. And maybe set it to sine wave. So now it's going quite fast to the left and right side of the stereo field and moving the sound. So let's hear how this sounds. But let's reduce the rate here to 1 bar. So let's play back the whole arrangement and hear this effect in full context of the track. So you can create really, really powerful effects with these modulators and have all different parameters of these plugins change. And again, it's worth to talk about the nested device structure that we talked about earlier in an earlier episode. Because these modulators can only modulate parameters in the nested device chain. So this tool device modulator wouldn't be able to modulate a device that's after in this chain. It can only modulate devices that's within this container, this tool device container. So if I add some other device after this, say we add a reverb, and add the reverb here. And if I deactivate the mapping here, you can see it's only these buttons that appear in this bluish kind of hue, this bluish kind of color. So you can only change or modulate these parameters from this modulator. If I want to modulate something in this reverb, I need to go in here and create a modulator for the specific reverb and attach a modulator. So there we have a classic LFO sine wave affecting the length of the time of the reverb. So that's important to know when you're creating your device chains and you want to modulate certain plugins. But as I mentioned, you can always modulate the devices in the nested device chain within this device container. So for this reverb, if we add some kind of wet effects, maybe an equalizer in there, and make a peak node here. If I activate the mapping for this reverb modulator, you can see it can change the values of this equalizer. And the reason is because it's within this nested device chain within the reverb, rather than a separate device in the device chain. So it's important to understand this nested device concept, and that's why I spoke so eagerly about it earlier in an earlier episode. Now you can also modulate, now you can also automate these changes that you do to the modulators, and also have modulators modulating other modulators. So we could have this second modulator, if we press the mapping here, we can have this first modulator change its rate by this other modulator. Right, so that's all for this modulator video. I hope you grasped the concept of the modulators and that you need to have them in the same nested device chain in order for a modulator to affect parameters in the devices in that chain. If you have any questions on the modulators or automation or some other Bitwig related question, you can always reach out to me on the Discord channel. Okay, I hope you had a nice time in the Bitwig Studio Masterclass. See you in the next episode. Bye. Thank you.